Welcome to the Climber Dad channel. We focus on inspiration, education for creation, and we are building a climbing wall in our front space at the gym right now, and I wanted to show you how to texture the walls. I've gone through several different methods of texturing the walls, and I have a pretty good method right now. I'm not going to say that it's the absolute best method, but it does work, and it does work for a good cost. To make this cost effective as possible, I am purchasing play sand and then screening it myself to take out these large chunks. So if you would like the same screen that I'm using here, I will throw a link for that down in the description below so you can do that yourself. I will be using this homemade contraption to blow the sand onto the wall, but I know not everyone has an air compressor. So I'm going to run down to the country store and pick up something that I've heard may work as well. More on that later. Now it's time to paint. I like to use a good high quality latex paint here. I've found that floor paint that does not have additive on it works the best. Once you get a good amount of paint on, you must spray the sand on there before this dries. I typically work in smaller patches than you see here. I've actually already sprayed some of the wall with sand. Now with wet paint on the wall, it's time to test our second option here, which is a hand fertilizer spreader. And it seems to work pretty well, although the blower is much better. But if you don't have an air compressor, this is a good option for you. It works way better than throwing it on by hand. And I will throw a link down in the description below for you to pick up one of these babies yourself. Now this blower is fairly easy to make. It consists of a recycled Gatorade bottle and an air nozzle. Now we drill holes through the Gatorade bottle to insert the blower, and then we glue that in place to seal it up a little bit better. And then for the part of the tube that is inside the bottle, we need to create a notch so the sand can go into the tube and blow out the nozzle. Something that I've noticed about using this is that when the bottle is pressurized and that pressure is consistent, the sand doesn't come out a lot, but when it is depressurizing, there's a ton of sand that comes out. So what I do is I will tap the trigger consecutively and let up on it. So it's not a consistent flow, but it works pretty well. So now that we have the know-how, it's time to apply that to the rest of the wall. You'll notice that as I'm working here, I'm stopping and spraying as I go. So I'm only painting about 2 feet of section of wall and then spraying it. That is so the paint is really wet and the sand adheres to it well. Now we don't want to end the process here. We need to lock in those grains. Depending on the quality of paint that you have, you need to go over it with 1 to 3 coats more of paint to lock that in. And then after we paint the rest of the wall, we are going to put a clear coat over the top of that as well to keep the scuff marks at a minimum. Now the best clear coat that I've found for using in this application that's budget friendly is going to be a one part epoxy paint designed for garage floors. It's designed to stand up to your hot tire marks. It's probably going to clean off the shoe rubber pretty well, or at least that's my hopes. Whichever clear coat you choose though, you do need to make sure that it says that it is water cleanup. Water cleanup means that it's going to adhere to the water-based latex paint that we put on the wall before. Well, I hope this helped. If it did, please give me a like and subscribe, and then get out there and share this knowledge with your friends.